Music is the last stage in the process, the creative part of the process, where you can really direct the emotion of what you want the audience to feel. After the writing and after the performance, and besides all the other sound design elements that are important, the musical element is usually called upon to help shape the emotion of what the scene's about.
Spike, this bomb could go at any moment.
Buddy, what are you doing?
Spike, get in the harness.
G-A-B-C-D-E-F-G. G is four.
Spike, four. There's no time. You get out of there.
The first and most important stage is the spotting session that we do, where Amin and I, we sit down and watch the show from start to finish, and we make pretty detailed notes about where we think all the music should go, how it should change from one scene to the next. Is there places where we don't need music, which isn't a whole lot of places in the show, but that spotting stage, I think most composers would tell you it's really one of the most important stages of the whole process, because you just kind of take a look at the big picture.
Generally speaking, Ari does more of the urban, groovy, ballad-like stuff, and I'll do more of the orchestral action stuff.
And then we go to our respective corners, Amin and I, and start writing. And we decide in that spotting session who's going to cover what. What cues am I going to write? What cues is Amin going to write? And then the clock starts ticking away, and then we just sort of reconvene a few days before we need to actually deliver the material, and we'll all sit down together and we'll watch it from start to finish and decide if we spotted it correctly, if there's places where maybe we thought we needed music but actually we don't, or maybe we thought there should be rhythm here but it actually doesn't need it.
Eddie, you get out of there right now, damn it, right now!
60 seconds, I'm not leaving him down there.
Eric, one man downrange!
Spike.
Very fast. When we see a story and when we see the rough cut put together, exactly what we want to do musically. Before we play to the producers, we get a chance to listen to what we've done, kind of have a huddle session. And we kind of make sure we're happy with it before we even present it to Anthony and Bill.
Sam, buddy, talk to me, please. Spike, Raph, talk to me. What's going on? You guys okay? Spike, Raph.
Raph? Are you hurt? Raph? You hurt?
Yeah, I'm good, man. You okay?
I'm good.
Spike! All right. Raph!
Boss, it's Spike. Raph and I are okay.
When you're watching a show that's got great performances and great writing, and then the music is kind of doing its job, it's just this kind of synergy that happens. And when it works properly, it's really quite a feeling.
Sam, talk to me!
Go find our guy!
Copy that.
Sam, you copy?
Sam? Come on, speak to me, Sam!
Chief, we got a 1066, two explosions underground. Let's work together, tight perimeter around the plaza, right? No one gets in. And we damn sure talk to anybody who comes out.
The score is not so much there to be noticed. It's there to enhance. There's times where we have to be the leader. And I guess maybe it does become a character in that sense. It's like the music becomes the main focal point, and then it steps back and lets the drama happen.
A lot of trouble to go through for a gym bag.
Yeah, we get a couple of these calls a year. Usually, it's nothing. Baby Cakes, we haven't had a date for a while. See that yellow box on her?
Mm-hmm.
That's a new multi-ray plus. Gives her a nose like a Doberman.
It's very easy to get inspired on a show like this. We love the characters. We connect to certain characters. I connect to Spike because the character he plays is very nerdy and very geeky. And that's me.
Jules, let's clear the plaza.
Come on, let's go!
All right, get up top now.
Spike, can you get inside there and defuse it?
There's gotta be countermeasures. I do one thing wrong.
Yeah. Okay, it goes up. I get it.
Boss, there's gotta be another way in here. Venting, ceilings, there's gotta be another way.
Yeah, copy that. Spike, Raph, everyone down there needs to find cover right now.
Things that I add to a scene, really, they make a big difference, but it's not like I'm having to create something that's not there. it's already there on camera. The performances I find so good. All the actors, some of the stuff I find very moving, and that's the best inspiration.
It's bricklaying. It's filling in rhythm lines, bass lines, pads, piano lines, percussion lines, melody lines, and just stacking them all up line by line until finally you have this large mass of sound.
Six, two, IR's down, opening the box!
Spike, you got it?
No, I gotta get the fuse out.
Help me. Okay, easy. Okay.
Flashpoint is maybe a little bit of an unusual cop drama in the sense that there's quite a lot of emotional parts to it. While we're doing a lot of action and chase and suspense music, especially in the first season and first two seasons, quite long sections of just talk downs, you know, where you have a negotiator that's trying to talk someone off a ledge or get them to put down the knife or the gun. And those two areas are, I think, a big part of the sound that we've created for the show. We're constantly walking the line between energy and suspense versus emotion. And sometimes we'll get notes back that say, you've gone too much into the emotional world here. We really want to keep the clock ticking. We want it to feel like there's still something very suspenseful and we don't know what's going to happen, or vice versa. Sometimes we try to keep the clock ticking and they say that, you know, you maybe have lost some of the emotion that we're going for here. So those are the times when we go wrong, but when we do it right, you know, we're walking that fine balance.
You looking for a motive?
Without much luck. Too many companies, too many targets.
Let's try and get a read on the bomb builder.
You're gonna track him down, get him to help us stop it.
Okay, so, motive, financial, political?
Terrorism, grudge to settle.
Give me half.
Underscore music is very different from songwriting in the sense that it's not about the obvious melody. There is no lyric. The lyric is the dialogue of the film. So you kind of start with that in the sense that the lyrics of the song already are there on screen, and it's your job to provide the harmony, the accompaniment, the rhythm, the counterpoint to what the scene is, not only musically, but dramatically. So sometimes the music has to just hover because a character on screen is coming to a conclusion about something.
Michelangelo Scarlatti. What were you thinking?
Just do my job.
Come on.